Hey, Don back. Okay, so got my little bucket, my carburetor cleaner, carburetor, set up my little bench, put some cardboard on it. It's an old door that I use mostly for woodworking, and I don't really want to. When I turn this over, it's going to go with gas everywhere. I don't want to eat all the finish. It doesn't matter that the door I don't care about. I just don't want to eat all the finish off of it. And I think all that gas that's pouring out is going to leak. There's a crack in the side of this bucket. I don't have another one. Let's see if that'll come off. I'm going to have to go get my stronger gloves to keep from ripping these. No, I think it's going to come off. There we go. Buy that up there out of the way for now. Okay, carburetor. Yeah, I'll stay down there because what leaks can stay down there, and then I can move up this way. Anyway, I'll put the cardboard on it and everything so that could work good. But I got me some carburetor cleaner. I already had that, so. There's my accelerator pump. I don't know if that's the, if it's overdoing its job or what the heck's going on there. I'm going to try not to waste this stuff. But definitely want to get the grime off of it so that when I take it apart, it doesn't get more grime in it. I think I used about 3 cans last time I rebuilt this, probably. Yeah, now I'll set it down in all that. But I did blow the dirt out of this pretty good when I got it out. Normally I'd leave my air compressor blowing while I'm working, but can't hear a thing I say when I do that. But what I'm gonna do, I think, is wet it down. Save as much of this as I can. Once down in there, I can use for wiping, but if it doesn't go out that crack. The crack's up kind of on the side. If I can kind of remember, oh, there it is. If I can kind of keep it setting to where it's not all settling in that crack, I ought to make a red mark there or something. I ought to get another bucket for, I think, probably paid $2 for that. You know, think about those things when you're not needing them. At least I don't. Okay, now, I'm going to blow it off a little bit. Well, that'll blow that junk up in my face. Take this rag and just wipe around on it a little bit here. Then I'll blow it off a little bit, probably take it out of the bucket. I think it's time to do that before that gets dry. Yeah, a little bit's going to get on my deal in a minute, what I guess. I think I got most of it poured out, the gas. No, I didn't. Drain. That's what I want, is the gas drained out of it before I start taking it apart. I mean, there's probably still going to be some in there, but... There we go. Everything I had to take apart in order to take it apart. Let's put this somewhere. There. Or it won't be breathing it quite as much. Let's see what I can do about blowing some of this off. Go turn that. I'll leave the gloves on until I get it blown off. Thank you. lot of dirt and grass in my tool tray there. I want to get some of that out. This pair just about done all with it they can do. Okay, now. Gotta have space to put my parts, so then I'll start to. I'm gonna let this run a while. It needs to build up, so I'll have it when I need it. What I'm going to. These gloves are probably already getting holes in them. They're definitely sweaty and driving me crazy. Yeah, I think I've used them enough. I'll get rid of that pair. Okay. Now, if I want to, I can even set it down. I think I might want to. I got a chair that goes up pretty high. There we go. Well, when you sit down and it squats, but I think I can see good enough here. I wore myself out this week, so I deserve to sit down for a while. Okay. And get those little. I'm gonna get that one off the back that's the screw. I think I might have lost this one here. And I found a screw in my bucket, you know, my backups of screws. Besides running the sound of my video, it's vibrating my head off. Oh, all that noise. My other chair won't go up harder than this one, but this is alright. This one actually won't lean back, so it's good for this kind of thing. The other one leans back. Well, I got another one that's a little shorty. It leans back too. Actually, you can make it taller, but it's not the hydraulic kind. You gotta screw it around and around and around. It's an old fashioned office chair. I just leave it all the way down, and then if I'm need to set down low, I can use it. Oh man, this is a brass screw. Never did break on me or anything. That's probably from some kind of a electrical wiring or something. Got a washer and a lock washer on it. Well, it's just a aluminum carburetor. It's not like it needs a lot of torque on it. Let's see. Just put my screws right there for now. I did get, oh, I forgot to bring them. I saw two more bottles that I could grab easy that were in the house when I went in there to go to the bathroom and stuff. And I forgot to bring them back with me. Let's see. I'm probably going to end up wanting my nut driver. I just brought the 3/8 socket set because that's what I had out. I'm not used to having, I got 3/8, 1/2 inch, and 1/4 inch. I'm not used to having all these choices. I'm going to go get that. That other one, it's got stuff that's just right for doing this with. Go get that 1/4 inch. Yeah. Those were the Americans. Yeah, I think that'll do. Now for my nut driver, when I get to where I can use it. It's not the best nut driver, but it's kind of cool because you can change out the sockets real quick, but it doesn't, it's magnetic, but it's not very good, strong magnet. And it's aluminum shaft, so you can't, I don't know if it might, this is a earth magnet in there. I don't know if it'd make it, ruin it to try and magnetize it on the battery like I always do with everything else. Let's loosen it up first. I haven't had this, no, this is the one I've already, no, this is the back bolt, the one I haven't had off. So let's just go ahead and get it off. Let's see. See if we're still recording. Yeah, okay. Get off and see if, what it looks like. Right when I said it was tight.
There we go.
Okay. Yeah, I had the front bowl off when I put the fuel transfer tube in. I knew previous videos is how I started all this. I just thought all I really needed was a fuel transfer tube, check the lights and blinkers, and go get it inspected. Then I discovered my spare tire had blown out sitting in the back of the truck. Even out of the sun. I always thought it was the sun making them, you know, overheat and blow out, but they just blow out because they want to. When those things get old, they blow out. And that one that was in the trunk was a, I had four of those I had bought used, and they all did that. Every one of them blew out long before the tread wore out. They're crap tires. I've had my BF Goodrich do that, a few of them over the years, but they were 7 to 10 years old. Of course, those could have been that old too. I think I knew the date. I learned how to, I don't remember now, but there's a way you can read the codes on them to find how, when they were made. And I had learned that a few years ago, and I remembered it long enough to buy some tire, you know. Well, I remember it for several years, but when I got to where I drove less, you know, more and more of that junk escapes my mind. So. But all I gotta do is go back and look it up. Somewhere. Yeah, I'm gonna leave that on there so that when I flip it over, I won't be bending my choke butterfly. Let's see. Now that should be ready to come on. Oh, that one's dirty looking. Got some bad gas junk in it. Old gas. This way. It's got, I didn't even think I had any carburetor cleaner. This is maybe what's stopping me up. See, it was not getting fuel, it wouldn't even idle, and then when I did give it gas, it was finally figured out it was flooding it, killing it. So I knew then that I tried a shortcut, and I usually it turned out to be the extra long cut. It was hard to get to that up there on the truck, so I left it on the truck, took the front bowl off, and put the new fuel transfer tube in there. Take that off. Doesn't want to come off. I'll wait till I get that front bowl off. Yeah, there's gunk everywhere. And that's not a gasket sealer either. It's I don't believe. No, I think that's just residue from the old bad gas. So the whole thing's full of that crap. I don't know, I'll look through it, you know, there's a slight possibility. I mean, the kit in it is not that old, but well, I don't know. It could be 5 years old or even more. But that's not old by my book. But I mean, the gaskets are still okay. It's not old enough that the gaskets are bad. I forgot that there's a plate in there that comes off. I mean, if I could clean it up real good and put it back together, and I wouldn't have to spend 50 to 75 bucks on a kit or whatever they are. I don't remember. I didn't look them up yet. I still have my box and the leftover parts from my last kit. So I'll be able to find it easy. It was hard to figure out the numbers to look that up and get it. Did I order it? I don't remember anymore. I'm going to put that over there in the... I think I just broke my tape that I had holding down there. I've got this cardboard. It was a box. Anyway, it's folded over right here. And, it's, yeah, I'm going to put this down in here. Give it a spray. Of course, you can't see me. I forget the camera don't follow me. I'm used to using a headset mic or something. Well, last time I did a big project out here, did that camera quit?
No.
Years ago, 2009, I remember because I saw the files recently. I used two old computers and webcams. They were very low resolution. Well, it's been a week out here working on this truck, and I wore a wired headset mic, a real cheap one, and it worked really well. You could hear me when the air compressor was running, when I was welding. So you could hear what I was saying, even if you couldn't see what I was doing. It's just so hard to do that with these cameras because I have to keep... Well, one will quit on me and I have to use another one, so I have to keep switching. And when I was using the two webcams, one of them was just doing like a surveillance cam. It would just take a screen, you know, JPEGs every time it saw movement, and the other one was the video. And I was using VLC to stream and save the video. So VLC media player recorder. It's Video LAN. It's made to do a lot of stuff. It's really a good application. It's complicated to do some of that stuff. It used to be, I could do it better. They changed the way you set it up, and it's supposed to be easier, I think, but it's harder for me. I used to know how to set it up to do all of that just the way I wanted to. And now every time I try to do it, it doesn't have all the options that it used to have, you know, to set the settings, and I knew what to set it at. Now it's like cryptic. It's a wizard, and it's supposed to make it easier, I guess, but it just makes it work. I don't know what to set it on to make it work. It just failed. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. So it's really aggravating to try to use now for quite a few years now. For streaming and stuff. Of course, it did take a lot of trial and error to get it to work that other time, too. But once I got it figured out, I mean, a lot of it's my memory. I don't remember with that wizard, the time I get it set, I don't remember what I set it on last time hardly, just vaguely. Let's see if I can pull that out of the ground or something. Anything on my little table. Okay. Get it all poured out already. Need more gas. There it is. I was looking for that other washer. Little bitty ones, thin. They're just flat washers, little thin ones. I think those were the originals from 1992. Well, there might have been some in that carburetor kit, I don't know. Could be. I haven't had it apart. I may have had the bowls off once or twice, but it doesn't seem like it's any good. Oh, there it is. It's alright, it had something on it, some goop or some sealer or something. I used to use black sealer. Sort of this reddish looking stuff. The reddish stuff shows up more and looks more crappy when you get it everywhere, that's for sure. But it's good. I think it's better than that black junk. The black junk used to get hard. I guess there's all different formulas, but it would get hard before they ever came out with this silicone stuff like this that's high temp and all that. It's the black junk was good. It would make a gasket. It was called Former Gasket, one of the brands. And yeah, my fuel transfer tubes in there good. This one, it's got goop in it too. Oh, some of that is gasket sealant. That could have been causing me some trouble. Because what it was doing is it wouldn't idle and it would keep dying like it was starving for fuel. Unless it was actually getting flooded and I couldn't see to tell. You know, if the idle jet, you know, that's gasket sealant. Oops. I went to throw it on the ground and landed on the table. This float didn't look bad like this other one did. It didn't have all that, so much crap in it. I had no problem with it. Worked fine. It idled really good. It's just when I gave it a little gas, just a little, even, it would just bog out. And I thought it was not getting fuel. I thought it was cold most of all, but then I figured out it was. There's my accelerator pump. There's the whole one of the orifices for that. This off of here because I don't want it. The rubber stayed in there, but that. Now let's put it on here. Yeah. I want it on there. Okay. So, I think it's working. Feels okay. It's not, you know, it's springing back real good and everything. That's the float spring there, and there's another spring inside of the accelerator pump there. But it's a diaphragm pump is what it is. And, you know, I put that in there with the kit not too few years ago. I need to get something to put all this junk in. I see I've got a bunch of stuff I got to get rid of. Just so happens that I had I saw this and I thought, oh, that's old, and I thought, I'll see if it's any good. Some hand cleaner. No, it was not any good. And the lid's cracked. It sat there in this heat, the sun shining on it in certain points and times of the day so much that it's still sticky. I usually save them from holding bolts and stuff, but it's kind of jumping and I need to blow it out a little bit at least. I've knocked the stuff out of it. Seems that I have a valve on my air tank that I used to could just turn it off and then I could leave my air blower on there and all I had to do is flip that valve back and forth. Now, if I leave the air blower on there, it leaks down even with the valve shut. Just started that just recently. So I've got to unplug the thing, air blower, turn, shut the valve, turn it off, It's not automatic. It's a portable tank, and it's an old Sears air compressor that's kind of a portable air compressor. It doesn't have a tank, you know. It used to do about 100 pounds, and now I think it only do now 85, maybe 90 if it's lucky. It's getting pretty wore out. I thought I had that blown out good, but I didn't. Yeah, and I got just about as much on me as I got out of this thing when I blew it, too. That's some of the best cleaner. There's two kinds I like, that, but it's gritty, that orange junk. But it doesn't make your hands stink forever, and then if your hands are really bad off, that stuff that's stinky, I use it. Stuff that has, like, petroleum stuff in it. This is especially good if you're in the truck, and you'll smell like a lemon and orange. I mean, orange instead of kerosene. That orange stuff anytime you just clean your hands up, you know, without any other than it feeling all gritty kind of bugged me. Now I'm gonna put all my bolts in here, man. Put that in there too. Okay, and I'll put all my goop on here for now. And that's this one. Okay, it doesn't have any goop in it. It's already been recently cleaned out. This one, this carburetor. I was trying to be careful when I keep forgetting what I just saw. Yeah, it's recording. I try to be careful when I put some sealer on the carburetor side. And I try not to put too much and put that gasket on there, and then I didn't put any on the other side. Sticks your hands like crazy. Where's that paper towel? Okay. And I don't really want to. I was thinking to myself just now, maybe I should just blow it all off and quit fooling with it, but I don't want to blow it into the little holes. Now, this could have stopped me up. I could have been why it ran good. Might not have been the old gas. This could have been my fault. That might have got in some of these little holes. I'm trying to see. I see what I got. It's all like it never really completely dried. It's like slime, snot or something. Like snot. It definitely was not. I tried to be careful, but I guess you can't be careful enough. So it probably got into some holes in this that where it shouldn't be. I didn't think I had that much on there, but I did. It squeezed out on the inside, and probably is the reason that it ran good for a while, and then at idle anyway, and then started acting like it was starving for fuel, and would die when it wouldn't idle anymore. And of course, now I know now that the problem when I gave it gas, it was actually flooding out. Of course, it could be that the flooding was happening at idle. Even. I never saw it. It would die before I could get around there to see it, you know. So I never saw what was happening, like if it was starving for fuel or flooding when it died at idle. I think I just scratched my nose with gas fingers. It's itching like crazy now, kind of burning. I gotta turn this one. I can see it myself. I'm trying to show it in the camera, but we'll try to compromise. Yeah, there's a lot of that stuff. I did not think I had put that much on there that it could do that. But evidently I did. Okay, here we go. There's not any in these two jets right here. I can't remember which ones are idle jets and which ones are run jets or anything. I wanted to do a little research and refresh my brain But I worked from can to can late this week and last week, and I just do a little reading while I'm eating my lunch and a little more while I'm eating supper, and then I go straight to bed. I gotta go to bed at least by 5 or 6 to get up at, you know, 4 or 5 to get out here by 7:30. I never make it. I think one or two days I made it at 7. I was aiming for 7. One day I said, I'm gonna go out at 6:30 because I realized the sun was coming out at 6:30. But I never made it. Okay, so at least out here there's a shade tree, but there is enough light I can see. Just right up in the edge of the garage there's just not enough light right there for me on my little bench. But I knew I didn't want gas all over my table saw bench. So I went ahead and did it out here. As long as there's in the morning here, when it was 78 when I first got out, it's probably 80 something by now. It rises fast. It was 98 yesterday by the time I went in. And it got up to 100. I have a thermometer, indoor outdoor thermometer there in my room, and I looked at it, and it showed 100 at around 7:30. No, I didn't step. Did I stay up that way? I don't think I stayed up that way. No, I didn't. Anyway, whatever time it was. Went to bed at 6, I remember that. It was before, maybe, you know, 4-6. Put this up here carefully. I still don't know if I might want to use it. Well, it's not a good idea to use this RTV stuff. That's how it deals with gas, by turning into snot. Well, it's supposed to stand up to gas. I have to look and see what, I think I have two brands in there. The one I used was the one I had bought. It had the most in it. But that just turned into snot. I mean, I don't even know if it was actually helping. It's probably the only seal good because this back gasket's still okay. I won't do that again. They usually tell you, I think they tell you in the instructions, but a lot of people will say, don't put sealer on your carburetor gasket unless you really, really, maybe it's cracked or something, you know, if you just don't want to buy another one, you can't get one or whatever, because of this right here. So, okay. Well, haven't found any of it in any orifices yet, but, I don't want to blow, I want to blow it off instead of digging at it like this, but I don't want to just blow it up in there further. Right there, one spot that might piece of gas. That was not. That's actually just a part of the interior part of the gasket that broke off. But let's take this curb tile and lock this down. Yeah. So the. Gas never let it dry. None of it did, not even the part out here on the edges. That was a bad idea. I always try to, well, when I was young, when I first started learning to work on cars in 73, 70, when I was 16 years old, hurt my first car. I had a lot of trouble with. You just had to use gasket sealer, or your gaskets were gonna leak. But they actually do. If there's any, there are a few things that are better these days. But I think the gasket material is actually better these days.
I
don't know. If this seals any better from day one than the older gaskets, but I think it may last longer. I'm not sure. This one's not that old, so I can't say about this one. But the older stuff used to get really hard and just useless, you know, break and crack. You couldn't hardly get a gasket off of any age without it just cracking to pieces. That's why I had that roll of gasket material pretty hard now. It's gotten hard over the years. It's actually pretty good stuff because it's not unusable. I learned how to make gaskets. There were times when you couldn't get one, or maybe I couldn't afford one. It definitely takes a lot of time. One like this, that would be a real trip trying to make something this intricate. Just a plain gasket with like four holes in it or something, two or three holes to make them. Put that under the tripod so maybe I won't destroy it by accident. Now this goop right here is not in the it is now. That's my finger. Doesn't seem like it's in that pump there. I don't know if that's part of the accelerator pump or what. Nope. There's the accelerator pump. At least I believe that's what it is. Okay, yeah, it has a probably a relief valve there, and that's where I think it pumps out and goes through. Oh, there it is. Full of goop. That's exactly where the accelerator pump goes. So it's full of this stuff. There you go. Screw up. Let me go get a paper clip. There by my thumb, it's just full of that little hole that goes up to here, and that may be, I would have guessed, just out of powers of deduction, that that's why it's dribbling like crazy when you give it a little gas. I guess, but that's accelerator pump, yeah. Which I guess even if you I guess accelerator pumps some, even if you don't hit it real hard, you know. I guess maybe it pumps every time you hit it on this thing. Used to the older ones and the old Carters and stuff. That's what I always worked on. I never had a Holley till I got this truck in 92. I always had Carter 2 barrels and 4 barrels, Carter AFB 4 barrels and stuff. I took them completely apart. A lot of times I would just clean them and stuff and put them back together, but I'd buy a kit if I needed it, you know. Especially, usually I would just buy like separate little parts like accelerator pumps. They were always going on. Yeah, that's got goop in it. Let's see if I can see on the inside. Gasket sealer. Don't put gasket sealer on your carburetor, just like the big boys tell you not to do. They were right. Blow on it from the inside, or hit it with that carburetor cleaner from the inside if I can find where it comes out. Because if I go this way, it's just going to jam it up in there further. Imagine it goes to, may go to those jets that hang over there, hang over the middle of the carburetor. These things are intricate. The more I take them apart, the more we will see just how intricate it is. I don't know if you can see in there, but there's four these jets that hang over. You can see the bees pretty good. That's where it was trickling. I could see it trickling from is this one. I never could see good enough to tell if it was trickling out of that one. It was just a bunch coming out. So I don't know. Maybe it was building up. It's kind of weird because it was like the hole was 10 times too big. Like the jet was gone kind of thing is what it looked like to me. Maybe it is, I better look. But that is clogged up. Can you see that from the bottom? Stuff. Every time I reach my finger in there to put some back in that lid as more comes out instead of putting any in. This jump really needs to come off, but I'll probably take most of it off. Not right now. Okay, let's see. Not sure what all I would have to take apart to figure that out. Yeah, there's the vacuum secondary deal. That's what makes that noise when you open them up. That's working. It's okay. Yeah, there's the vacuum. Well, I think the top. This one is to do with the choke. Looks like it's part of it. This one here. I don't know. It's hard to tell where they end up going, but there's one up here that. No, that just goes straight to the top of the carburetor. So that's like a. I used to know the terms battery and all that junk, but yeah, that's straight up to the top of the carburetor. I don't remember what that went to. And down here is the one that I had going up there so I could spray starter fluid in it. But the one I want to open is the front one. So let's turn it up like that. There. Yeah, I don't see any jets that you unscrew from that. That's just reflection, I can't see it. At least I got a light out of here. Yeah, I don't see any jets that you can unscrew from there. So, oh yeah, all these screws, then you can take the bottom plate off. Which I might end up having to do. I mean, if I order a kit, I'll take it all apart to get to all the parts to replace them. Another little hold there, another one there. I think I'll put a little air pressure on some of these holes, blow that, you know, the other way. I can't get to those, really, I don't think, to try to do that. Yeah, I don't know how to get to that. That's where the triple, you know, where the dripping is. Dripple is, but right now I think I'll try that and see if it blows up this little hole. I'll just keep trying. Nearly.
I've debated about folding that carburetor over. I knew I'd get into it, but there was lots and lots of splinters on this edge of the table, so I thought, well, I don't want to get it. I'll end up getting all kinds of splinters. Goes out that vacuum line, but it also pushes this up. At least I think it does.
Does have a lot of junk from the bad gas because I didn't take it off before, so that's all going to be clean for sure. Oh, there's a pin that could come out right there near that vent. This isn't very easy to get out, though. It's right there. Magnifying glass is the shield to keep it from hitting me in the face. Seems like a good idea. I won't stay. Okay, no. Like it's awfully tight. I don't want to tear it up. I don't even know if I can get another one. Thought if it was loose enough, I might take it out. Let's try putting a little air through these jets here. Must eat your fingers. Well, I can see down in there where the goop was. There's not any more in there. I guess I might have blown it out from one of those other holes. Yeah, it's clean now. I don't know if I can show that or not. At some point, when I was blowing through different places, it's cleaned up. No more red junk in there. I don't know. I didn't catch when it happened. Thank you. take these big jets out